Hello everybody and welcome back to a spot of Minecraft. Tonight we have an actual rough vague plan of what we're going to do, and it involves that kind of weird structure you see in the sky behind me. But welcome in there, Penguin, the troublemaker known as Eris. The other troublemaker known as Mr. Smith. Mayhem and I lost count in my head of who I was speaking to there. But welcome in there, Eris Mayhem, Mr. Smith, Gary as well, and the Penguin. Let's press some buttons here before everything else goes. Actually, we need to sleep before we do anything. I need to take it out of cinema mode. There we go. And we need to put our junk on. But today we have a mission. I've been busy on the server. It took hours, but I've gathered up nearly everything that we need to build this structure. Only part of it seems to be showing up at the moment, but trust me, there is a bigger structure here. So we're going to travel. It's going to take two trips because of the amount of resources that's required. So it's going to take two trips to transport. Well, technically one trip, but right now, our sort of time, we'll come back and we'll make the second trip. I'll show you all the bits and bobs that we need. So this is almost everything. There's a couple of parts that I don't have because I simply don't have them. I don't have some of the these new blocks. I don't have any of those, so I don't have any of them. But that decoration, we're using that for anyway. So the stuff that's in all these multicolored ones isn't strictly necessary. Well, the multicolored shoulders are needed, but the contents isn't, because I've got rails in here.
Gary,
we've got Gary in one of these. I've been hard at work AFKing here. We now have an absolute ton of concrete. It's nowhere near what we need for the entire project. Not even a fraction. But the white concrete is full. Yeah, the white concrete is now full. And there is random assortments now of the other concretes. Well, not very much of that one. No. Or there's no brown concrete then, basically. Anything in here? There's a handful of some of the other colours. That's how I watched off Raiden who break the game. Oh, yes. Last night after the stream, Mr. Smith and I were browsing on Steam, and you came across a new game. Was it Sim Airport or Airport Sim? It was one way around or the other, and it's there's a demo of it available, because the game is not out yet, so it's just a basic demo. And whereas Mr. Smith immediately went to go and have a look at, you know, what he could do in the game, I immediately went to see, ooh, if I do this, will it not work anymore? And well, airport sim, was it there? Indeed, Gary, we are doing a bit of mining and crafting. Oh, please tell me you didn't buy it, Gary. Please tell me you got it on Game Pass, because it comes out on Game Pass in possibly about 3 hours time. I'm sure it comes on Game Pass at midnight, because I looked at it last night and it was like after the stream, and it was 1 hour, sorry, 1 day and 1 hour until it was available on Game Pass, which means that at midnight tonight it'll be on Game Pass. I should certainly think it would be free. We're Game Pass. There is no reason to buy that game, and I haven't really seen much of the game, but there's lots of people been saying it's been boring. But we'll wait and see. I mean, I'm gonna have a go of it on Game Pass. Not next week, but the week after. I'm gonna give it a bash, just to see what it's like. I'm not overly fussed, because I kind of forgot about the game's existence, to be fair. Oh, Eris has contributed to the Australia. Now, we tried to test Australia mode last week. There is a slight technical issue. I will resolve it, but the way that I manipulate the Australia mode. It didn't work under testing last night, but I may have had other things, may have been countermanding it, but I'll get to work. Well, sure, you guys get it all filled up. We should probably start moving this before I spam too many rockets. Right, how many slots does that leave me? Right, one of these boxes, is it one of these boxes or one of those boxes contains rockets? As long as I'm taking the rocket box with me. And I've still got a few slots, so I might as well, because we may need more stuff. So we'll carry one more box, there we go. So I only need to come back for this, and I don't think there's anything other than concrete and rails in these. Yeah, concrete rails and redstone. Actually, just in case I've made a mistake, I would rather take the full box of redstone blocks with us on this first voyage. Of course, if we get killed and we lose all of this, then that's about 6 hours worth of resource gathering. Not to mention however long I've spent at the concrete machine. I don't listen to a bitch and I play and find out. Exactly, we're going to find out as well. I'll find out anyway in a couple of weeks' time. As long as... Actually, right, hang on. Let's click on here for a second. Because I don't know whether or not I have to install it or if I can just stream it. And, you know, like how we did for some of the other games. We did it with the cloud service things. Pre-install with Game Pass. It doesn't have the countdown clock on it. I think the countdown clock, I think, was on the other app. All right, launch the other app again.
Yep.
Drag that down. Close that. I mean, you would think it would be on the streaming thing. How big a download is it? Come to think of it. Starf. Is that how you spell Starfield? So we've got install now. Yeah, three hours. 3 hours until it's on Game Pass. So yeah, it'll be taken over at midnight. And I'll get to see whether or not it can be just streamed. If it can be just streamed, oh, that'll be so much easier. Okay, anyway, let's get back on track. What other mischief have you been up to today then, Gary? Hang on, which way do we need to go? Let's see, let's go through here. Easiest way to get to where we're going to be going is on the Nether roof. When we eventually get up there. Slowly. Oh, you know what I should have done? I should have put one of these things where we're actually going, and then I would have a fighting chance of knowing where we are. So let's just take a look at the map. Is it there? Actually, right in the Nether, it is not too far. It's not too bad. We need to get to 0 by 1,000... 1,200. Okay. Or rather, 1,200 by 0. That's not too bad. Am I going the right way? I'm not going the right way. I'm going to go this way. Actually, I guess it shouldn't be too bad at all. It's just a quick jump. It's 300 on the Z. Should be coming into view any second. Somehow I thought it was going to take longer to get there. There it is. That's where we're going. Okay, this is the structure that we're going to be building. This is the bridging station between the two rail networks. Obviously, once we get the things down, and I'll smooth out the terrain surrounding it, and I'll work these hills back here so it looks a little bit more natural. But that'll be further down the line. Yeah, but this is the monstrosity that we're going to build. We're going to have to set up a spot where we can start working from and get digging, I suppose. This spot here looks as good as any. Let's start deploying our junk. I think realistically, like, the coloured ones maybe should go somewhere else. Because the coloured ones have all got things that aren't strictly necessary in. And of course it's getting dark as soon as we get here. Which is the one with the bed in it? That one's got a bed in it. Before it's too late. Of course, when it comes time to building this, it's going to be... I'm going to rummage around to find which box has got what in it. Oh, it's one shy. There we go. No one will ever know. Pop those in there. Why do I keep putting colours? Well, there, somewhere in amongst this build, I've put one of every colour shulker. But these ones here, the coloured ones, have got just the stuff to build the actual rail lines in. So I just put those back because we're not going to need these for a while. I mean, one of the basic interchanges takes me 4 hours to build. This is a double interchange with all of the extra extensions that I've put on it. I think this is probably like an 8-10 hour project maybe to build this. So we're pulling an all-nighter, everybody. All right, let's bring that down a smidge. It'll just lag out momentarily. And you get that number down to about 65. We've got a lot of ground to cover here. Oh, look, they're clear. Only 30 minutes? Oh, I don't think so. You're staying up all night, Gary. I had a word. Mrs. Gary said it was all right. You were allowed to play out. Why? Well, I didn't get, didn't dare put my tools out. Probably fall asleep. No. Well, you got to leave the speakers on loud then. Hang on. What time is it now? Computer, set an alarm for 10:30 p.m. There we go. I thought I'd do that to help you out there, Gary. Now, where's our fun time boxes? Right, let's get one of those. I'm going to stick that there. I'll put a torch down. It'll get rid of the snow, but, you know, we'll... I just need some working lights. We can put the snow layers down again later. It's a damn you. I still didn't get the shovel out. Gary, what are you doing, man? You're supposed to tell us to get that shovel out. Is it, no, it's cold. I wish it was cold like this video here. It has been so hot here today again. I went out to sit with the girls with the intention of doing a bit of work from my tablet, and it just didn't happen. It was so hot. I should probably build some towers to mark the corners. I've got a whole lot of dirty. I'm gonna just mark the corners, then I know that everything in the middle can be demolished. Bloody SnowRunner. Okay, that marks that corner. There's a two over, like overage here, but that's all right. Cause that's just because there's a tree that overhangs. Oh no, that's lava. Lava causes indigestion. Exactly, we have no idea what you're talking about. What is this SnowRunner? Exactly, there's no bloody snow in SnowRunner. I think was it just snow on the second map? Was it? I can't remember. Was I chatting with you, Gary, or was I chatting with Mr. Smith one night when you were saying about SnowRunner, how it's one map is snow, the next map isn't snow, then and it's like back and forth when they release a DLC. I'll sculpt the land at the end of it. I may be crap at designing buildings and stuff, but I am good at sculpting land in Minecraft. I just don't like doing it because it is so time consuming. Can I make that one any bigger? Is what she said. Okay, so this marks everything that we need to clear. Everything between those two bits to 53. I should probably level it to just where I've got that marker there. Okay, I suppose we'll begin. this is what's going to like take even more to the time it's going to take for this project. But whilst we're doing that, as I said before, what sort of mischief has all been getting yourselves up to today? Have you been cybering and punking again, Mr. Smith? And have you got all those Latin words down there by now, Gary? I expect you to be able to speak the language fluently by now, surely. I mean, you've been there over a week. That sounds like a suspicious yes, you've been playing the cybery punkery. Oh, bugger. I'll just take the soft stuff off first, since I've got the shovel in my hand. Then we'll come back and get the hard stuff in a minute. I find that incredibly difficult to believe, Eris. No one here believes you. Oh, that's what it was, those plants in the way. Okay. Is that just all plants? It doesn't matter, I make a too deep in certain areas. I'm just going to rebuild it anyway. Only problem is I wake up and forget. Hang on, isn't there like a Google Translate thing now for Latin? I'm sure that's in amongst all the languages that you can choose. Do they give a reason as to why you have to learn it in Latin as well? Is it just because it just happens to have been on the syllabus forever and nobody's, like, willing to change it? Oh, you've been having some snacks there, Penguin. We had some fish and chips with a bit of garlic bread as well for our tea tonight. And I mean, I tell you, last night, I'm sure, much to Mr. Smith's amusement, all night, I was burping ginger from the Chinese meal that we had. It's like every 2 minutes when we were trying that game, it was like, oh, I'm burping more ginger here. What was it again? It was like a ginger and pineapple, and chicken, or meat product. Is this definitely the outer layer? Yeah, this is the outer layer. It's the global language of flowers. Well, can you not tell them that the global language of commerce is English? It supersedes. Because you're only going to be using it in terms of making pennies. Just start making up some names and just send... Oh, no, please don't be my doom. Oh, this is not good. Can I go there? Oh, I'm going to dig myself out here, aren't I? I'm just being... Oh. Okay, we're going to have to be very careful. Is that the bottom layer anyway? Yeah. Right, I think we're probably a good time just to sleep anyway, so we'll jump back into the bed. And begin carving in the morning. You can speak sheep. You can speak with... Are you based in Wales now? They're all a bit funny with the sheep over there. I said the same thing. Why not use English? As it's kind of got exactly. When I was doing some work yesterday, Gary, I was listening to more of Al Murray's stand-up, and just where he's saying that he on one of his things he was talking about God, and he says that without a doubt God is British. And he says that's why we don't get earthquakes in the UK, because you don't shit in your own back garden. just come to my head there when you said that. Wee. It's been years and years since I've watched any of his shows. And just now of course, because you watch one and now YouTube now just throws them all at me all day long. And good evening there. Can I say your name without setting off? Is this the right button? No, that's not the right button. Maybe that's it. Yep. I think we've got, just turning off the device behind me. But Alexa Bliss, welcome in there, mate. You join us tonight for a spot of Minecraft? Hope you've been behaving yourself. I don't strictly need to level this bit out. I'm just putting them in anyway. Should I start digging? Is it right? Is this the height I definitely need to be at? Yeah. This it all has to be at this height here. would have brought some TNT, but... that'd have been too easy. yes, indeed. Oi, who are you shooting at? Actually, can I fly away? And he might despawn. Because I don't know if I can be chewed with the thing that you get from him. You don't often see this biome here anymore, do you? Or is it, I very rarely see it in my travels. Like a frozen city. That's like that reminds me of the tower of in Atlantis, the central tower.
Alexa, computer volume 10, computer play wet fart.
Not long to go for that alarm clock to go off as well. Indeed, we can temporarily fly. But we're going to have enough shovel to be able to do this bit. It's unplugged now. You'd almost think he doesn't trust us. I don't know. What are we going to do with him? But Gary... you know he really wants to listen to Barbie Girl anyway. He sings along with it. Should I carve out? I'm going to maybe carve out a double on the outer perimeter here. At least then we can maybe see where the lava is, hopefully. Ah, the beauty of the everywhere addition on the commands there, Gary. Right, how deep does this have to go in relation to the lava? Okay, let's just go back because I think I stepped up once, maybe twice. Right, so we know it's going to be at this height. Let's see where this goes. That soup burned your tongue. It's always... that's the thing, right? I love tomato soup. But that first bite when you're just testing, is it hot enough? And it rips the roof of your mouth off. And you're like, yes, it is hot enough, but now I can't taste it. Okay, we are going to intersect the top layer of stuff. Or are we? Right, so this is actually where it's going to be. So I can leave that where that is. Right, let's just not touch it right now, and I'll build directly into it when we have the blocks in my inventory. So for now, let's just... Oh, yeah, right, so I need to be at this height. So I'm going to leave... leave a little bit of this perimeter here intact. Quickly sleep. Uh, Literally this, you read my... Yeah, is that you got have that? Has it cooled down nicely? Oi! How rude! Oops. Right, I can take that block and that block. Let's cut that down to just bare bones of what it needs, and then we'll preserve as much of the lava as we can on the corner when we get to it. Let's just check. Yep. So actually, yeah, I just want to make sure that I'm on 64. Why 64 is where we need to be. That's why you need a sun to be a taste tester. All right, then we all better get there. All better get busy. Right, so we're still on Y64. Should I just, for the convenience, fill that? No, I'm not going to fill that in. I'm going to let it anarchy ensue. I need to be out one. I think the shovel is just too much. So we're still on 64. Get rid of that. Oh, it doesn't matter actually about the snow blocks. They'll disintegrate as we go anyway. If Gary rejects, we can take his tongue. In it. Yes, we'll harvest his tongue whilst we're getting his kidneys. Yes, we've been discussing the operation. We thought the best thing to use would be rusty spoons. I always think of it, it's not just because of salad fingers, but also if you know like Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, where, what's his name, says, you know, his brother comes up to him and says, why is it always a rusty spoon, or why is it always a spoon rather, for cutting his heart out? He's like, because it'll hurt more. Alan Rickman? Wasn't that one? I keep forgetting his name. Am I on 64? Yeah, I'm still on 64 here. Is that just a drop? That's just a drop. Okay, we have an inner perimeter at least now. On 64. Now I've just got to get rid of all this junk in the middle. Without falling to my doom. What's that, Penguin? I'm 57. Gary, I promise. Sending the adoption papers to you now. For Grandpa Penguin. Ooh, bugger. It's going to be a problem because when he can't see the ground. You had me 14 years. Yeah, this is going to be a problem, keep falling down here. Do I need it on full display? I know I just want to be on level 64. Let's drop the schematic and just try and keep to level 64. And stay in between the bit that we've marked out. Just keep carving. I like the way the rusty spoon is. It's been quite some time since I watched the old Salad Finger documentaries. It's all real, of course, everyone knows that. There was someone who was doing, I don't actually, it might have been that Theorizer bloke who was doing like a deep dive into what he thinks like the lore of the universe is for the Salad Fingers fellow, and he's actually got PTSD from the war. How are we doing for wear and tear on the thing here? So there, I guess it's just hell. No way PTSD does that to you. I'm gonna have to look it up. Someone put a reminder in to look for the Salad Finger, theory videos. Yeah, I'll see if I can dig it out. That's the one. penguin. Wait for the cooldown and put another reminder in. I can't remember what the cooldown was. A couple of minutes, maybe. Put a reminder in that I need to send everybody, including yourself, your tracking numbers for your various parcels. Because they were all in the post this afternoon. So your key rings are on the way, Mayhem's key rings are on the way, and Frodo and Sam's key rings and the wooden box are on their way to them. But more ideas, I need more ideas for things we can make with the laser. If you're going to wear them as earrings, you have to send us a picture of you wearing them as earrings, Air Penguin. You're going to wear them as earrings, and you need a long red wig as well. You have the Bounty Bounty logos at the bottom. We got that leveled. I'm trying to see if there's anything apart from the. I'll take the stones out. Oh, actually, we're doing the slow walkie thing now. Well, we could probably eat, and that would solve the problem. But you know. Sometimes I think, should I have brought a beacon? But nah. By the time you build the beacon, most of it's all soil anyway. Or dirt. We are indeed building something out, but I got to level off the terrain first before I build it. Quickly to the bed. Thank you for putting that of a reminder in there. And what was that you said above there? I had an idea for some channel points the other day, but felt impolite to say. Now I forgot. Oh, if you got an idea, put it in. Someone's gonna give her a giggle. Is this a building? Am I building this directly on somebody's house? I am. Hang on, this is one of the ones that's got those secret chambers.
Turn off lamp.
Don't these ones have like a secret chamber in them at the back or something? Well, whoever this person might have lived here, I'm terribly sorry, but you're going to be evicted very soon. We'll have to do an excavation. I didn't realise there was a hut in the middle of this. But this is what happens when the indigenous folk get in the way of modernization. This railway depot will be built here. Back and forth, off and back. As I swear, if you find the secret room I've never found, that I'm 30% certain I'm going back, because remember that this server's been active for years. I'm certain there is one of those special ones where it goes down into the underground thing, because it's supposed to show you how to cure villagers, because that's like the whole point of that particular one. I'm certain there is one somewhere here, because I did it for the achievement. Something is telling me that that might even be it there, you know. Actually, no, that maybe is a tree. But I'm confident that I came many, many years ago. It would have been about 3 years ago. I'm sure I went here, and it was somewhere in this area that I found one, because it was part of one of the achievements. It's advancements, they call it, isn't it, on Minecraft? I've only got a couple of those left to do. So they are real. Thank you for at least. Yeah, they are, because I'd say the whole point of it. We'll take our bit out of this now. Yeah, there you go. There is one. I thought it was the back. It turns out it was here. Let's take a look down here for the penguin. So we'll go down here. There should be a villager and a monster. Oh, maybe he's not. But that's the theory anyway, because this is supposed to teach you how to do. Because look, you got a potion here, potion of weakness, because that's where you got to do a potion of weakness on them, and then you give them a golden apple. If I'm thinking correctly, it's been a long time. I'm not 100% confident, but there should have been something. I tell you what, I'm going to step out for a second, just out of curiosity, and also actually be honest, this gives you a better look at what we're looking at here as well. There, penguin. Ooh, a geode. Right, let's go back in there, because I just want to have a quick spy just for demonstration purposes. And good evening, happy cat. What mischief are you getting yourself up to? We are leveling the area at the moment. We've evicted a poor indigenous person from their home. Or rather, maybe they're out fishing, because they're not here at the moment. But when they come back, their house won't be here. I mean, they're welcome to take shelter in the base once it's completed. Once we get this terrain leveled out and begin the ridiculous construction. But did you win on I was going to say Dysentery 2. Tonight or this afternoon. Thankfully, I seriously thought it was just a huge prank. No, it's there as a tutorial like I said, for teaching you how to cure villagers. The birds of habitat. And you've been good. You've been behaving yourself this afternoon. It was hard work, but you won in the end. I was trying to, because yeah, when I was doing a bit of, I was in the garden for a chunk of your stream.
Happy underscore cat underscore lady. I'm in desperate need of a cookie fix. Will you be my cookie hero and save the day?
I think we all know what Harry Cat's answer that's going to be. And welcome in as well there, Craig David. Another troublemaker, everybody. But I was about to say, it's this afternoon. After I came in from the garden, I was doing a bit of work at my desk before I had to go to the post office to get everyone's parcels away. And I could hear you saying that everyone was leaving your team, and I tried to see if I could connect to you, so I could to jump in with you, but it wouldn't let me join. I don't know what I've probably pressed the wrong buttons. But just when you're saying that everyone was leaving your team, I was trying to jump in with you. You're the anti-hero. Right, it's been it has indeed. I mean, I tried to do some work in the garden from my tablet today, and I couldn't even open the tablet. It was just so exhaustingly hot up here as well. If I had been up a few hours earlier, I might have even considered setting the camera up for this afternoon. It would have done a garden stream.
Craig David's cat constructs a massive boulder on a hill, intending to chase Craig Dav 1D downhill and squash her. However, when he tries to push the boulder, it rolls back and crashes into Kitty instead, leaving Craig Dav 1D unscathed.
He escaped again. And Captain Jukeman, welcome in there, mate. What adventures on the high seas have you had this week? It's over 26 here. You want to know? What temperature are we running here? It's 21.2 here, and it's 14.2 out in the garden. Another dastardly plot foiled, indeed. Might have been a light level. Maybe that's why it wouldn't let me jump in. I am thinking light level is the number that it, well, if you imagine this is the screen, it's the number that appears kind of like here on the Destiny screen thing. It's kind of like wee. It's kind of, you got your armor things. Is that the number that I'm thinking of? Is that the level, or is that something else? Because I can't remember what mine is. I think it has. Does it? No. Does it have a 7 in it? Is it 1-7? The first two numbers 1-7, or is it 1-6? I forget. I'll have to lawyer jump in and see. Got a new video gun when I played it the other day again. The number in yellow, yeah. Actually, hang on, right. I know this is out of date. It'll be out of date by maybe 2 weeks. But I did put a screenshot from, like, beginning of last week, didn't I? Somewhere in the game section. Oh, this game looks so pretty, doesn't it? Let's just bring that up there. The settings all dialed up to 11. So it's definitely around that, but maybe it's two, maybe it's three numbers higher. I think you hit 1,700 something. Yeah, it's something along those. I know it's at the very least it's two higher definitely. Because it's been quite a bit since I played. I've played quite a bit since that screenshot was a couple of weeks ago there, wasn't it? I'm going to have to go and get into a shovel. Well, we can... You can do some things with the copper. Actually, I should really keep the copper if I can. Because it's I have a very, very short supply. Whenever I need copper, like for this build here, it's a case of I've only got the copper that we need. Because I don't have that much of it. We do have a farm for making copper, but it is painfully slow. There's bound to be a new design. I mean, that was like 2 years ago. There's bound to be a new design that's probably more efficient. I love how I started higher than both of you. I read half of one line and half another there. I got very confused. Started higher than both of you all. Up to 17, you're still on 16. You have to jump in. Have yourself a half hour's run around. I need to figure out how to trigger those two missions that I've got. Because as Happy Cat was saying, that's what's holding us back on getting that next rank thing, because at the minute the only thing I can see to do is bounties or those rank missions without having to cough up money, and I'm not coughing up any money for Destiny. Should I continue building digging with this one, or should I I'll dig a little bit with this. Just constantly keep an eye on it. Now I'll go get the next shovel out of the box. We're not too bad for recharging them here, to be honest. Yeah, that was it, wasn't it? The new... Right, I know we're having plenty of pauses today. Let's right-click on here and go to... Actually, it's easier to go to library. Oh, it is. I think, where is it? It's come on the screen. Let's see, multiplayer combat games, Destiny 2, store page. So, recent reviews, mixed. but there we go, the next DLC is $83.99. And that comes out in February of next year. That's and an annual. I don't know what the annual pass is. It's probably just skins. Lightfall, 80 quid. You know where they can stick that. I mean, I know we have ignored like everything in Destiny 2. Based on my experience of Destiny 1, there is no Destiny 1 had no story. Yeah, it doesn't matter what anyone says. Destiny 1 had no story. I don't know about Destiny 2 because I haven't given it a chance. All right, that's this thing used up. Happy Cat has returned with a crate full of shreddies for everybody. Let's pop this here and get another... Oh, please tell me there's another shovel in here. There is. Indeed, they can stick that where the light don't shine. Now, another Fallout game. If it's a single-player game, I'm all for it. I don't really have any interest in the 76. I think I've kind of like just... As much as I bought it when it came out, it was such a disappointment on launch day that I just don't have any... I don't have any interest in playing it. If you know what I mean. Steve, welcome in there, mate. This is going to take longer than I originally anticipated, isn't it? This is a lot of terrain still to level here. And the tree fell. Evening, Steve. What mischief are you getting yourself up to there, mate? Oh, yeah, I'll just check that. I am on level 64. That's all right. Everything on this level has to be demolished. Oh, bugger. Oh, they're having another one of the sales there, Penguin. So does that mean that everyone who has discount, if they're doing a discount, does that mean everyone who has like the repeat ones, sort of, is it repeat one? The one where it does it automatically, does that mean they get a discount this month? Wolves went too far there. We might, Gary. We at the very least we might get one ring done. All right, they're doing it because it sounds like September. All right, I'll let them off. Keep carving through this. Oh, don't go too close to the lava. Actually, I'll take out this whole corner, then I won't have to worry about it. How is Johnny doing, Mr. Penguin? Just think yourself and you called Penguin. Good evening, Johnny. The man of mystery. He's been put in retirement. Do you think we're digging a hole here, but we also have the other hole that we're digging? Grinding away. At least I've got two more spare shovels. But at the very least, I want to get the outer ring built. Oh, that's a good idea. Tonight, right, on the server here, there's been a project that I've been working on and off for the last 3 years, and it's the rail network, because I designed a redstone railway system where you can put it. It's probably easier if I show you the map. So you put a ticket in, you go from a station, you put a ticket in, and it will navigate you to anywhere on the map. So as you travel through the world, you go through these little interchanges, and each one of these interchanges then puts you on the correct path for where you're for where you need to go. So you know, eventually they'll come into here, and that takes you into my main base. You know, then the railway lines, if you're heading up north, up here, you know, another interchange up here, keep going. This interchange here though is where we're kind of branching off right now, because it's going to come up here and along here, and this is going to be a mega interchange, which is going to bridge the gap between rail network 1, which is here, and rail network 2, which is still to be built 100,000 blocks away over here. Because you know, when the Caves and Cliffs update came out, because you know, like how other like servers, that they delete the map and start again. Well, for us, we migrate. So you know, you don't lose any of your old builds. If you want to start fresh, put your tools in a box and travel somewhere else, kind of thing. You know, if you want to start from scratch, just head out into the world. I haven't started building the rail network in 2.0 because I haven't yet covered the 100,000 blocks in between them. What was that there? How big is the map? It is big. So the where's 00? Right, that's where 00 is, just there. You got, like, so here's, which is 17. Actually, can I? I think it doesn't allow me technically to zoom out any further, but I can cheat and get as far out as I can. So this is as best as I can probably get it to render. It might be a bit glitchy for what we have. You do one, but you're allergic to work, Gary. Can you get a full day's work out of him? It's City Skylines in Minecraft. Yeah, it back in 2019, when myself and Chrissy and Royalty met for the first time, the server that Chrissy and I were playing on, I had planned to connect everybody, that because it was a YouTuber server, so everyone had was making YouTube videos every week that was on that server. Actually, I should check it because it's dark time. I'll let that regenerate in underneath, and we'll actually, can I, I'm going to move it across to here, if it'll let me, because I can let this render in the background a little bit. Actually, that's probably all it's going to render, really. That's probably not enough to get, yeah, it's not enough to go all the way, but regardless, anyway, where we are is where the bridging station is going to be, and that's going to be, that one will govern traffic between the two networks anyway. That's what's going to be built here. And if I go to here, I've already designed it in my creative world, so I'll just bring that up a few levels. I don't know if that's all the way to the top, but it'll get the idea. So this is what we're building here. So this is the mega interchange, which governs the two rail networks, and I've decided to pair it with, back when I started doing, like, Minecraft videos, I used to make, like, weekly tutorials, and this was the redstone testing warehouse from my Bedrock world, so I'm recreating it. The redstone testing warehouse has all these areas marked out as well, so when you watch those videos, because they're still on YouTube, you can see the size and shape of it, and you can see it from the blocks. You can measure it out yourself on it, so it makes it easier to copy the build. And in the bed. Looks like a dungeon map from Skyrim. Let's see if it's just popped in anymore. Oh no, right, we zoomed out. But yeah, I said that's the plan. we also have another hole that we're working on. Wait for it. Is that where it is? Yeah, it's up here. So we've got this excavation that I'm working on as well. And technically I also have another excavation that I started. I've made like an alpha site, so this is the Stargate Command, SGC, and this runway goes deep into the mountain, all the way to about here. This runway goes all the way along. Right, this lags out a moment just whilst I'm doing this. I just need to get this below 60, actually 60 will probably do. But it makes it so much easier when I can bring out a ghost version of the build into for my creative world. What's that there? Yes, it does, from Steve. Oh, the penguin's going to put the kettle on for everybody. But not before he contributes to the Australia mode challenge. Right, actually, whilst we're playing Minecraft, how many times have we tabbed out the game today? hang on, this is not the right place. Hang on. I'm too lazy to open up another instance. So let's just find. Right. I go here, and then if I click on today's video. Then I go to my channel. Too many times indeed. How do you spell Australia? It's A-U-S-T. Actually, it's probably enough. There it is. So 2 years ago, we did the Australia Mode Challenge back in 117. actually, when was that? The 11th of June 2021, and that was stream 68 on this server. What number are we up to now? I know we took like 8 months out. I'm trying to find where we're outside. Yeah. So it's like a click where somewhere that's not showing landscape. Maybe I'll go back here to this point. There you go. This is a better illustration of what we're going to do. So you see, this is how the world is. So it's not like the monitor's flipped or even like, because the hot bar is still where it should be. But yeah, have those two little mini farms been there for over 2 years? I was supposed to put those there for a couple of days. It's still there now. But this is what we'll be doing though. Should you succeed. And Gavin Happy Cat also contributed. So hopefully this will be suitably trippy for you. I'm going to get sick watching this. How long did we do it for? It was an hour and three quarter stream. I think I was getting used to it by the end though. Then the menus are all the right way up. But I need to get it fixed because there was a glitch last night when I tested it and it wouldn't work. But I'll get it to work, because if all else fails, I'll just switch Minecraft into default mode. It could be a glitch caused by the fabric loader that I use for Minecraft. It's like reaching up for all of it. Remember, like, left is right in what have you, and right is left as well on this. Taking a ride on the train. Okay, let's go. Keep on carving. But no cheating, mind. I don't want to find out that you've turned your tablets, you've locked rotation on your tablets and turned it around the correct way. Actually, if you're on your tablets, you could do that and trial it, to test it to see how nauseous you feel right now. How do you think our Aussie cousins feel? They live like that their whole lives. Well, you know, it's only fitting punishment for an island of criminals. That's what we do to punish the convicts. You'll pass or you'll pass out watching it, Mrs. Smith. Oop, bugger. Both. I'm just looking at that line there. Ada and her Easter egg commands. I did something last week though. I revealed an Easter egg command to Mr. Smith. whilst driving him slowly mad in the middle of the night. Indeed, Mr. Smith. It was just like, from Mr. Smith, it was like, why am I sitting here at 1 o'clock in the morning watching a film about people that just say the word rhubarb? It's a good film, though. It's only 35 minutes long. That's why we have so many Aussie bar staff. They're returning to the scene of the crime, exactly. Ooh, how are we doing for durability? Durability is okay on this at the moment. On carving. But how many of you guys have also seen the rhubarb film? I keep on forgetting his name, but what's the name of the fellas that are in it? I can see all their faces, but I keep on continuously forgetting their names. The chap from the goons. Keep on carving. That's it, Figgy Seacombe, isn't it? Yeah. I'm burping again, but at least I'm not burping up ginger like I was last night. Only except this, what a day to say to you. You were flirting with Ada. Can't keep his hands to himself, that fella. He's always flirting with our Lord and Master. The Almighty Ada. In preparation for his sacrifice. But never mind the Australia thing, it just going back and forth like this is making me head funny. Time we're an hour and 18 minutes and we've gotten a good chunk of it leveled. Yeah, but no, we might get a little bit of the base done. As in the base level, that is. Not the base. Uh-oh. I think so. Moving the Dominion, I want to make sure my best put it on the right. Hashtag sacrifice Craig David. Let's just take a little spy from above and see how much progress we've made. Actually, we're not doing too bad, really. We just need to remove this. Because the snow will disappear, like these snow layers will disappear when we try to build on them, so that's all right. So we're not doing too bad. We've gone through one I think we'll probably do 2.5 shovels to dig out what we need. Keep on spinning. Which episode of The Witcher or moment surprised you the most and why? I'm still disappointed with that last season of The Witcher. Notice I say the word last season of The Witcher. Was that, did she still want to sacrifice? I thought she'd moved all her seeing eyes into Mr. Smith. But you volunteered as tribute to Ada. And if you would like to volunteer a tribute, !! Hunger Games to volunteer as tribute. I'm coming in from District 10. Craig David from District 7. Love that segue. And it's so handy that I have it on the pedals now, along with this. And the emergency mute. Which I will struggle to undo. I still can't decide where's the best place for the pedals, but I think I'm going to prefer it the other way around, so have them backwards, rather than putting my whole foot on them, because if you're resting your whole foot on it, you're going to be constantly pressing it, and I can't really... I mean, if I sacrifice the middle one, but then why would I jip myself out of a whole button? But if I have it backwards, because I often have my foot resting on the metal spoke of the chair, but and then from that I can use just my toe just to press one of the three pedals. Oh, the games have begun. Did any of us actually enter? Or just three of us in there? And Mr. Smith's already dead. So just myself and...
We have our victor. The winner of the Hunger Games. Craig Dav 1D. The capital is astounded by Craig Dav 1D's victory in the Hunger Games. They won by befriending a flock of mischievous capital pigeons, who delivered secret messages and supplies right under the noses of their opponents.
There you go. Craig David wins. See, all that flirting with Ada's paying off. Right, this shovel's almost had it. Gotta keep the old girl sweet. Ooh, we're past 10:30. Did that alarm clock go off, Gary? Computer, play air raid siren. That's that shovel done. And plop. One in, one out. Oh, you're trying to sleep? Oh, we can't have that, Gary. But we're doing an extended stream. We're going to be live until 9:30 tomorrow morning. And Gary promised he was going to stay awake during the entire thing. Oh, Mrs. Gary, if you're there, if you're still awake, can you jab Gary in the ribs? Just to make sure he's fully awake. Ooh, how rude. Whispers, sorry, Gary. Leave her out of it. No, it's too much fun. It's too much fun. you know your family agrees with me anyway, Gary. Hang on. Oh, I got stuck there. So, what's on the mission list tomorrow then, Gary? What classes is it that you're doing tomorrow? We know Thursday is Latin Day. But what's on the cards for tomorrow? So who am I kidding? Gary, just play, give them a back at full volume. Can anyone remember, just when you're bringing up Bon Jovi, that he had to call into a radio station quite a few years ago now because the radio station, just whoever the host was thought he was dead. And you had to ring up to say, no, I'm actually still alive. And for all you guys that watch the Penguins of Madagascar cartoons, they have a little remote control car that they drive around the zoo and when they go on missions. And not on all of the episodes, but some of the episodes, the license plate reads, I love Bon Jovi. It's a blink and you'll miss it. With the registration plate, plate, but watch out for it when you're watching the cartoons. Plant production tomorrow. So is that kind of like as in? Are we talking like plants, as in like flowers, like the mass production sort of thing, or like using farmland, or is it like greenhousey type things? Is what I'm kind of thinking. Not far from here, there's a huge place where it's like miles of greenhouses. It's like north of here. Maps. Can't remember where it is. A bit of both. So you take that road around there. Was it on this road? I'm going past it and seeing like absolutely loads of them. I can't quite remember where it is. That's the road that goes to Perth. I'm sure I was driving along here. Maybe I wasn't. Maybe it was when you come out of Perth. Maybe it was on this stretch. What we got here? Yeah, that looks like a tiny few polytunnels, doesn't it? He'd be the one that has to go around there with a watering bucket every morning. What we got over here? I'm sure there was some on this side of the road as well. Oh yeah, here they are. Uh-oh. Yeah, and there's more. Actually, that's not polytunnels there, is it? That's where they have them covered. But these are. Yeah, I knew there was a zone that had absolutely tons of them. Up here. Right, this is a problem. Let's fly away. Oh, you want some midnight cheese, Craig David? Quickly before they kill us. Oh, right, they'll all burn up now. Right, we better have a quick snack and see what the damage is on our equipment. Still got a fair bit to carve out here. Just keep digging. I suspect there might be a power surge. Perhaps you should have a word with your human. Was that in the depths of my soul? I tremble with the height of passion, Craig David. Yeah, it definitely must be a power surge. Get this area lit up. That's one thing about these builds, all of the exchanges, the interchanges for the rail networks, they're built like fortresses where nothing will spawn. So if you're traveling around the world and you happen to be lost or need a shelter, you can follow the railway lines until you come across one of these builds. Because they are probably the safest places on the entire server. Where am I on? I'm on 60. I need to bring that with 64, so everyone needs to be level with where I'm standing now. Of course, when we start building, we're then going to have to find where, oh, here we go. Can I get you to blow up? Yeah, get him to take out a few bits of this for me. I have to find where the stuff is in all those chests as well, as we go. You're gonna hear this noise tapping in your dreams tonight, everybody. It's like carving through the dirt. Did you ever watch the YouTube channel. The Y Files, I found it in the binge. The obscure conspiracy theories. Stick a reminder in, exclamation mark reminder, and then stick the name of the YouTube channel in for us. I'll have a look. There's one. There's a channel that I quite often watch before I go to bed. He does like disasters. Because I'm always interested listening to different videos about like the Chernobyl disaster. And he does, apart from that, he does like other disasters, you know, like building collapses and stuff like that. You know, like rail disasters and such. But he has a whole section on like nuclear incidents around the world. And, you know, he talks about like the criticality instance, you know, where you know, the demon cause, where they get buggered up, and then, you know, the person gets, you know, the various research places get knackered, like over like nuclear facilities that have had, you know, like the ones that like treat nuclear like the irradiate like medical equipment, those sorts of ones as well, where, you know, like people have just walked into the chamber because they weren't properly trained or even knew what radiation really was, and like old X-ray machines and stuff like that have just been dumped because, you know, that it got to the point where no one knew what it was. what's the name of his YouTube channel? 2 seconds, we're gonna tap out again. just to try and carry that extra little bit nuts. I'm sure the channel begins with a C, begins with a letter C. Or maybe it's the second part of the name begins with a letter C. Let's go down to the C's. Nope, none of those are popping. See, on my Apple TV, it comes up at the top. It's like the first one. I just click on it because I know that's his channel. Right, hang on. Let's have a look at you. I just type in that. It's not that one. Ah, here we go. This channel here, didn't begin to see at all. plainly difficult, but I definitely recommend watching this this guy's channel. I like watching all the nuclear bits and bobs. Those ones fascinate me. But I definitely give this one a watch. I don't know if I've added it to the bot on Discord. I'll check. So it's definitely one that should be on there for Ada to announce when there's a new video. As I think you would find it quite fascinating. Probably I'll have a little spy on that one though, Craig David, because Ada will remind us on Discord in the general chat after the stream, along with all the other things I have to remember. But it's just as well because I can't remember what we chose to remember at the beginning of the stream. Maybe I should add a command which would allow us to replay the things that we need to remember each stream. Ada does keep a log of everything we've ever asked to remind ourselves with as well, not just the dailies. Got all the dirt. I think it's just the stone now that needs to be taken out, which is going to be the painful bit. So what sort of mischief he's all got planned for tomorrow then? We know Gary's going to be doing plant production. But what sort of trouble are the rest of you getting into? I think what we need to do on the stream is we need to have like a, I mean, a Minecraft day would probably be the ideal time for it. We need to have a special section when Gary can come in and tell us tell us what the next stage of his studies have been. And no mischief plan for Mr. Smith as of yet. And you're going to play out with your mum tomorrow, Happy Cat. Are you going to get a big chocolate cake to share between the two of you? I was thinking about chocolate the other day. It's now been so long since I've last had any. I used to love the dark chocolate, you know, the cheap dark chocolate you can get from Aldi. The one that's in like, oh, at least it was in the little cardboard boxes. I used to love dipping that in my cup of tea. You know, you break off one, like, is it a little stripe of four? Dip that in your cup of tea. Closest I get to a cake nowadays is a toasted tea cake, maybe it's for breakfast. Well, you don't know if there's going to be any cake, but there'll definitely be a cup of tea, though. Go on, you know you want to treat your mum to a cake just for the secretness of, or will the cake mysteriously disappear? Oh, I just sit up here, we're falling off the seat. I still haven't gathered up those cookery books as well, so that we can choose what we're going to do when we do a real kitchen stream. We need another reminder in for those as well, and I'll take some pictures of the things, and I'll, if I take a picture of the book and maybe it's the contents page for each book, and then you guys can decide what we'd like to try and attempt by it. I mean, what could possibly go wrong? I mean, I can buy cater-sized barrels of mustard, surely. just add it to my favourites. I watched the guy who's a nuclear physicist at the in Germany. Did you lots of the Do you watch, because just when you're saying the guy that debunks all of them, or like those dodgy Kickstarters, is that Thunderfoot? Because I have watched him for absolutely years, because I find his videos to be quite fascinating when he puts that. I know he does a lot of like Elon Musk bashing, and I don't blame him because Elon Musk is a moron. The dumbest person in every room. Even the ones he's not there in. I've been watching his videos, like when he's been like, when he debunks all the different things. I do enjoy watching those. He's been a bit like thin on videos this past year, I would probably say. I've not really seen that much of them, but I say saying that, there is a new one that was released a week or so ago, but I haven't got round to seeing it yet. I think it was a week ago, vaguely. Is that his real name? I'm used to that name to start with. Craig David. But I do like watching. Watching his, like, you know, like when, like, things like the solar roadway. Do you remember that that rare nonsense? the idea of like putting the solar panels like on the ground in a car park where the cars are going to be covering nearly all of them all day long. It's like, yeah, that sounds like a plan. And yeah, it's supposed to be able to melt the snow itself with the electricity that it'll store up and what have you. And then they had that, what, like 5 meters by 5 meters, like test version they put in the city. And well, I suppose when it caught fire, it cleared the snow. But there was CCTV footage of the people, the scammers who made it, out there shoveling the snow off it. I was thinking as well, because they're lying flat, right? So, you know, when the sun is... Where's the sun in Minecraft? Well, the minute Minecraft sun is perfect for beating down straight on the thing. But let's say the sun was, like, there. It's only going to get a fraction of the power at this angle. Oh, yeah. The thing is, right, you know, everything that Musk moron says that he's... Well, apart from the fact that he gets people to sign over their IP to him so it looks like his whole family made his money out of bloody bank fraud, didn't he? But we'll not get into that. But yeah, I mean, all those things and what have you. I remember when I was in high school in the 90s. Actually, I could in primary school. Either way, primary school and high school. I remember there was a book. I'm sure its title was Future Worlds, and I used to love looking at it in the library. Had like all these, your flying cars and stuff like that in things like the tunnels and all that. Like those, they were all in there. And everything that he claims that he's made, I think, does he have a copy of this book when he was a kid as well? Because everything that he talks about is all was in this particular book that I read as a kid in the mid-90s. But I'm confident that book was from a lot earlier, because the books in the library at school were all slightly out of date. Can you remember the Gene Roddenberry? Actually, was it called Planet Earth? They made like two, I'll say, TV movies, because I think they were supposed to be pilots for what was going to be a TV show. It was never Gene Roddenberry one. I'm fairly confident I don't think it went to any series. I do remember there being just a couple of like TV movies I remember I used to watch. But one of them was where they had all these tunnels which ran underground. And actually, it was that inspired me in my very, very first Minecraft world. Actually, can we hop out to my first Minecraft world for a minute? I'm fairly certain I should be able to find it. But anyway, they had these tunnels underground, and that's what made me want to make... The very first thing I did when I first played Minecraft was make tunnels underground. And in my head, I was imagining it was like the tunnels that were underneath the whole world in that thing. I've got to think, what would I have called it? Let's try this one. It's a creative world, because I only ever started playing Survivor when I started doing my YouTube series. Ooh, it'll have to be converted, because it's in the old chunks, so this'll be laggy. Sounds like that Lockhart fella from Harry Potter. He takes all the... yeah, exactly. this looks right. This looks like Little Ember. Ooh, Little Ember's probably broken now. Yeah, Little Ember. So yeah, if anyone's seen the City of Ember, I made Little Ember. A little underground. This is all underground. I mean, I'm in spectator mode at the minute, so you can see it's beneath the mountains. But everything is connected by these underground rails, and that was what inspired me to make all of these. This is way, way back whenever the hell I first played. I was still working at the hotel. Yeah, so there was these little bits here. I just zoom down here. Actually, no, we're going the wrong way if I was going to go to the place I was thinking of. I wonder where this one goes. I can't quite remember where everything is, because I haven't been on this world for a long time. That's why it was at the very bottom of the list there on the single player world. Hang on, there must be something. I wonder if this goes to the Futurama bit. Yeah. And you know, there was one of these in the desert. And there's all types of little bunkers built all over the world as well. I know that's not really that much of one. But yeah, there's railway. If I follow the railway lines here, I can probably navigate to different places. All right, that was obviously a tunnel which never got finished. Is there more new series of that? I think if we go along here, if I follow this line here, I think this takes me to where I think I was trying to build Rapture. Or at least a mini version of it, mini Rapture. Yeah, this definitely looks like it. So there was a big, big underwater viewing thing. My attempt at the lighthouse. My first attempt at Redstone turned out to be just ludicrously huge to get a tiny door mechanism to work. I started building little buildings underneath, you see. Was even a little domed area as well. Yeah, it's obviously this is you know, I suppose crap is what we'll call it. Little apartments, you see, that were built into the side. Obviously none of this is textured. This is when I first started playing Minecraft long time ago. Big cruise ships. Well, there's some little ships as well. There's some little boats around here, around this little dock area. And this is where I was like, I built these modules, then I would copy and paste them to where I needed them. So all these different, these are all the different iterations. The secret bunkers all over the place, and these are like the door mechanisms to get into them. You know, these little secret shelters that are scattered all over this world. I love all the science things. If I was, believe it or not, if I have a BSc in molecular and cellular biology, I left and trained because I love science. For science. I love watching all those ones as well. Craig David. Indeed, I did enjoy the BioShock games. Back when I first started streaming them, I did start playing them, but the version, the remastered version that I've got on Steam just was glitchy all the time. I mean, it's probably fixed by now, but it just got really frustrating that after a couple of streams, we kind of went, just no, forget it. We're not going to continue anymore. Here is right where we are now is a really, I didn't build this. I put it into the world. I wish I had the skill to build this though. I dumped it in here to give it a look. That's why the border comes very flat here. It's the Lonely Mountain. And we can go inside. That's absolutely awesome. I mean, it's going to be a bit weird now, probably because, oh no, it's all right. It hasn't done those chunks. That's okay. But we can go back into here. He's massive. Throne room. Somewhere there's a treasure room as well. I think, is it off to the side, maybe? If I go underneath here. Oh, there it is. Oh, here are the mines, rather. The actual mines in the mountain. I'm sure there's a treasure room in here. That must be it there. So this be where Smaug be hanging out? Okay, let's have a look at some of the other things that are put into this world. Oh, for those of you that like the penguins of Madagascar, Actually, I think there's a bunker inside of this hill. Yeah, yeah, I recognize this this mountain range. But for those of you that like the penguins of Madagascar, if I can find it, hang on, right, I need to go back to... Oh, never mind, here it is. We got the Central Park Zoo. Or should we recreate this on the server? More brick. More bloody brick. I think I'm going to have to recreate this on the server. I do like the penguins. Get inside of their secret lair. Yeah, that is definitely going to be something we're going to do. We're going to recreate this in there on the server. Okay, what am I going? I'm going west. That sounds right. Let's just go underground because I need to know when I'm tripping the lines. Because we have something for the Star Trek fans as well. If I can find it. Actually, there's two things that the Star Trek fans may possibly like. This kind of feels right. Actually, yeah, I know where we are now in relation to it. So we got one of these. And if I go directly south from here. An unknown this must be yeah, that looks like a nacelle. Just see all the decks popping in. It's covered in snow because of course it's in a snowy biome. Here's the bridge. Ready room, Captain Shitter, conference room. There's a Defiant that way as well. I can't quite remember where it is. Well, I could find it following the railway lines anyway. But if we go down this way, there'll be a huge hollow. Actually, be two. No, we want to go at the second hollow. We need the second. It's not the first hollow. The second follow hollow. I've got to find the bloody thing first. All right. This mountain range looks familiar, but we are talking like well over 10-year-old memories. Yeah, I think we crossed this bit here. No, we're not on the server anymore now. This is my very first Minecraft world. When I first played Minecraft, this is the world that I used to just play in. I'm trying to remember. I'm certain you go south from where we were. Maybe we're too far over. Yeah, we've gone past it, I think, haven't we? This mountain range got a back window in it. Nope. I don't see anything through here. Evening easy. We're currently looking in my very first Minecraft world for a base that I made possibly 15 years ago. It's around here somewhere. Oh, hang on. Did I see a stripe there? No. It's definitely inside of a tall mountain range. I'm fairly confident of that. I wouldn't say that. I'd say it's somebody who had not long started playing Minecraft's base. There is another base which has got multiple floors, which is might like. I'm just trying to find the huge, because I was starting to make this huge bunker project, and I hollowed out the area that was necessary, and I built the floors. This is definitely way out of range, isn't it? I don't think it was this far south, you know. I think we're into new chunks now. We'll go a little bit, because I can always beam out. I don't remember crossing any water. And we're currently 4,000 blocks away. I think we've gone too far. Just jump into here. Yeah, this looks like new chunks, doesn't it? Just check inside of this range. Yeah, I think we've gone too far south. Okay. Full speed. What I might have to do is go to the end of the railway line, because there's no railway line connects where I'm looking for. I don't think I made a railway line that went that far anyway. Let's see, what have we got? If I look at this elevation, I might have a chance of seeing it. Indeed, we've got starships. There's a Defiant as well. I'll take you to the Defiant shortly. I just want to, because it's on the opposite corner of the map to where we're looking for. Here we go. This is what I was looking for. We did go too far south. So, in the side of the wall here, there's a big massive vault door. This is what I was building when I first played Minecraft. And then it comes down here, and I got all the floors ready, and there's two sections. There's a section here, and then if we go deep enough, it then goes into an even wider section. If I can get it all to load. But obviously these floors were never filled with things. The only thing that's there is the clocking mechanism, which was meant for doing redstone experiments. So the idea was this central shaft here has power outlets on every level, where you can take you can take energy out to do different clocking, like different tasks where it's going to keep on sending repeated signals and stuff out. I think I was doing some. I was learning how to, like, about music blocks here as well. I think. I said this has got to be like 15 years ago, but if we go down here into the server room, all of these blocks, they don't work anymore because they changed the way you do it. But each one of these checks and then follows an action, and what that was in this corridor. So ignore the bit where the hole was, but this corridor here, because you know the Matrix, you could come along here, you could open a door, walk in, and it would beam you to a different location in the world, via the Matrix style unlabeled doors. And that was the central clock which ran it. Obviously, I don't make clocks like this anymore. I've got much, much simpler methods of doing them. that was something I was trying many, many years ago. Now, if we go north of here, and if I go slightly... Sorry, south... I'll go north of here. Why am I going south? Go north, and I want to shift slightly over to this side, and we should come out to another spot. Probably easier we go above ground. Also, how are the girls keeping? It's a bit of a... At the minute, little stir fry is the one now that's kind of taken bad at the minute. Butter is doing amazing.
Ooh. 8P wants to bouncy with Gary D. Steele. Is all set to marry I think I'm a penguin 8P, and are going to kill I think I'm a penguin 8P.
So, he just couldn't handle it after a night with Gary. Well, here we go, we're back at Little Ember. That gives me a fighting chance of figuring out where we are now. right, go this way, till we find a single track. But yeah, Butter has made an amazing... there we go, I'll follow this line. An amazing recovery. Should we do in a couple of weeks to get our next injection? I need to go and sort that out. Actually, I probably need to sort that out tomorrow. I'll ring up because just to get that all that booked in. But the minute stir fry, she's normally when it comes to food, stir fry is feral, basically. And she's quite off her food at the minute. I don't know if she's having like a really bad molt. I think this is the right passage we're following here. Yeah, this is it. The underground hangar. The idea of the story was going to be, you know, the roof would retract and you know, you could you got your little Delta flyers and stuff and run about down the bottom there. What was I saying? So she's really off her food. A crop is full all the time, and she's only doing little tiny poops. So I've been massaging her crop all day as well to keep it. It's not like it's not hard. It's like cheap Play-Doh maybe. But I don't know if it's just because of the result of the molt. She hasn't really been shedding too many feathers, but maybe she's gotten stressed about now she's like kind of like under the weather. I don't know. Following this line, yeah, I keep following this line, and this should. Oh, we've gone too low. We've gone too deep. Dwarfs, we've delved too greedily and too deep. Which platform do I need to go to? I'm going to gamble it's this way. We're going to go this way for a moment. But yeah, I've tried giving her, you know, the buttery bread, as you do. And she wasn't interested. Feels right, at lunchtime, she'll share my sandwich. She'll share my sandwich with me. And she'll take a bit of that. And then, you know, a baby food, you know, the chick crumb, she goes nuts for that normally, but she's just not fussed about it at the moment. A comb is only her comb is like straight up, but her comb at the moment is sort of like halfway. I did take a picture of it today. I should put it on Discord. In fact, you know, I'll stick it on Discord now, because then if I get my phone, I'll put it on Discord, then I can bring it up on the screen, you see. One moment. Pet pics. Click on there. Oh, right, put the phone down there. Right, I'm sorry, what was that just whilst we were looking on there? Oh, have you lost two easy guy. Oh, poor little buggers. How's the rest of the flock doing as well there? Are they able to play out now? I know you haven't bothered with that, them arseholes dogs. Where's Discord? Ah, here it is. Pet pics. So normally her comb is straight up. She's, I don't know what the hell she's done. She did scruffy today on her chin. I don't know if she's gone like face first into the yogurt. She was eating the sweet corn. If I dig up wriggly worms, she'll go nuts for the wriggly worms and she'll knock them straight down. You know? But she's having a little snooze there because I was giving her a cuddle on my knee at lunchtime there. I'm also 5% certain that I am lost currently in this world. Somewhere there's a... Yeah, so it's the same as how I do it. It's, because they only get to play out in the garden when I'm, like, sitting out there with them where working at the desk. We'll see what it's like. I've got too much on tomorrow, but I would like to do another garden stream this week. So I maybe, if you guys are maybe up for it on, what day is it tomorrow? Definitely in the wrong place. Hang on. What day is it tomorrow? We're playing Minecraft, so it must be Tuesday now. So maybe it's Thursday? Because tomorrow's Wednesday, and I know that I'm busy most of tomorrow. I've got too much on tomorrow. So as long as the weather's not bad, we'll maybe do a garden stream on Thursday if you guys are up for it. It's been a few weeks since we last did one. Ah, this is not the right rail line either. One moment. Let's double back to here. Did I put any signs back here back in the day? Is it, we're currently working off like 15-year-old memories of this world, because I have not come onto this world for a long time. This might be the right line. So if we follow this, we might get to where we're going. Yep, this is definitely where I was looking for. There's another one for you, for the Star Trek fans. We got the Defiant. There is like other things dotted around this world, because I scattered things everywhere around this place. I've got rough memories of where things are. It would take a full stream, I think, to explore everything that I did here. There was the bunker that I was thinking of that had the multiple levels. I vaguely remember you come along here and there should be a side path to it. Here we go. So yeah, so each level had like there was one double level which had like a big cargo bay, and then there was the quarters for each person, and then at the very end there's like the administrator for that level of the bunker. That was the idea. The idea behind it. And you had, you know, conference rooms on this side, you got your canteen area, a cinema for entertainment. So each level, you know, your shower and bathroom sort of thing, each level was its own kind of like self-contained bunker. And then on one of the floors here, I think probably the top floor, maybe there was, I think, did I put like a main office for like, you know, the overseer? And there was this little trapdoor as well. This trapdoor opens up so you can open up the shaft. But yeah, that's just a quick run around on a very, very old world. Maybe we'll explore it properly one night. Because I can run a map on it so that I can know where everything is, and we can have a little play. Trying to find my way back to the beginning. Here we go. So if I go to the surface here, there should be, yeah. So this is, I spawned in, the world spawned me in for the first time here. And then I walked over here and started digging. Wait, what were we doing? We did have some kind of a plan. Oh, sorry, I missed it as well. I missed what Craig David wrote there. Sorry, I'm just minding my own business and chatting with the AI. gonna head off all this talk of computers and, ooh, bugger, hang on, we're gonna die. Bloop. Well, you have a good night there, Craig David. Behave yourself. No, we won't. But you have a good night there, mate. Probably, to be honest, I think we might wrap up now anyway. We didn't get as far as what I had hoped, but I mean, through the week I'll finish excavating this. Actually, before we do anything, let's carve away this bit here. Because I just want to see the underside of the little house here. So you can see the secret shaft underneath this fella's house that we've just we've just demolished. I want to be on 64, which is where we're at here. So yeah, so this maybe we'll make this into a feature. I mean, I don't know, where does that go in? Right, it's right next to the portal. I'll maybe just leave a trap door here. We'll put like a different block there whilst we're building it. Because it intersects this line here. And whereabouts is right? That's the interchange. All right, yeah, I know what it is. Yeah, so, so that's going to be there. Yeah, we'll do something so that we can still access the little secret chamber underneath. Yeah. This poor fellow, we've destroyed his home. Keep on carving. I'll have to come back with other tools to flatten all the rest of that, but yeah. shall we go to relative safety? Yes. Pace back and forth. Oh, where'd this bugger come from? I'll maybe through the week as well, I'll put a line of torches between these two points to make it a little bit easier for navigating back to base. There we go. Was it all the rest of doing well? Because I haven't had a chance. Haven't been well this last few weeks. I couldn't get down to them to find out what's going on with them. Poor little babies. Still getting all the cuddles from Moon Juice as well there. And we'll go down and check on the girls in a minute as well. Okay. Wait for Minecraft to unload. Oh, Discord is still full screen here. Okay, let's have a... Oh, no. No, I did it again. Right, I need to press this. This will just take a moment. Okay, I'll try that one more time. This time I have the right instance activated so I can actually access the channel. Okay, so tomorrow night we will be... Broken Sword. We'll continue Broken Sword 2. We were on a tropical island. I forget that we were in the Caribbean. We finished up in the Caribbean. That's where we were last time. Tell you what, let's go and see. Alright, he's a bit disturbed. He's a very disturbed individual. Let's go over and say hello to him. Oh, I spelled it wrong, that's why. It's got one of those letters in the middle of it. tomorrow we continue with Broken Sword. We have a bit of Alan Wake on Thursday. Mandatory Mass Effect Friday, everybody. We are starting Mass Effect 3. So we'll be doing the prologue mission and probably Mars. We should be enough time to do both of those missions in one like reasonable like length. So that's the idea for them. Saturday, Fallout New Vegas. I don't know where we're going to go, to be fair, with Fallout New Vegas, because we are really stuck on levels. Everything is behind a level wall and we have no good weapons to do any of the quests that we have available to us. So I can only see that going really well. We've got a bit of farming sim on the Sunday, and we're going to play a bit of Ori. As I've said before, I've 100% Ori multiple times, but whenever I go in, I always go in completely forgetting everything from when I previously played through it. So we're going to do a little bit of that one there. It looks beautiful, but it just the sounds, everything about that game is such a masterpiece of platforming. Ori. That's all I can really say about that. let's press this button here and go and see if we can sort out this psychopath here. So thank you all for watching. Have a good night. And if I find the right button here, we'll see you all next time. Thank you for joining me today. If you are enjoying our journey and would like to see more, then please rate, comment, favourite and subscribe in whichever manner your chosen platform allows. If you are joining us on Twitch, Mixer or YouTube, where we have loads more for you to watch, from our live streams to all our episodes across our various series. You can also drop by and say hi over on Discord, where we chat about everything from Minecraft to books and movies to tabletop games. But most importantly, thank you very much for watching and have a lovely day.